Good day, my name is Lynn Brandenberger. I work for the Department of Horticulture and Landscape Architecture at Oklahoma State University. Today we're going to talk a little bit about soil fertility and managing soil fertility for crop production. To begin with, soil fertility really is a key part of growing crops. The soil that you see on the ground here has all sorts of nutrients for the plants. And actually, plants require 16 different nutrients. But the main nutrients that crops use are nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium. Nitrogen is kind of like the gasoline that you put in your car. Phosphorus and potassium are kind of like the oil and the coolant that's in the engine, because they need to be checked on a regular basis, but rarely do we add much once we're up to the right level. Nitrogen, on the other hand, is used constantly by the crop, and so a lot of times we need to add a lot of nitrogen to grow a crop. The crop that you see in front of here is cabbage. Cabbage uses a lot of nitrogen. For a commercial crop of cabbage, we're talking about 200 pounds of nitrogen per acre. And that sounds like a lot, and it is a lot, but this is a big, fast-growing crop. So one of the things that a farmer has to decide is how much fertilizer to add. So if you've taken a good soil sample and sent it in to have it analyzed, it will come back and it will give you recommendations for your particular crop. It'll tell you how much nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium to add. If your soil pH is too low or too high, it will tell you what to do to help adjust that soil pH. And pH is a critical part of soil fertility, because soil pH affects the release or the availability of all the nutrients for the crop. Where all vegetable crops want to be is slightly acidic. So on a pH scale, which runs from 0 to 14, we'd like to be somewhere between 6.5 to 6.8. You know, if you're in the low sixes, you're 6.2, 6.1, that's okay. If you're in the high sixes or even 7, you're all right. But the ideal spot is that 6.8. That will make the most nutrients available to the crop, and it will grow the best at that pH. The other thing that goes on with soil is it basically stores nutrients, and it stores water for the crop to use. It also provides the ability for the crop to root down and to be anchored in the soil. Now, if you live someplace that the wind never blows, you might not understand that, but in Oklahoma, where we get 60, 70 mile an hour winds, anchorage is important. Trust me, it's very important. The other thing that soil fertility, managing it properly, does is that it allows you not to waste money or nutrients. You know, if you're just kind of taking a shot in the dark and you're putting out fertilizer and you think, well, that'll be good, and it might work. But a lot of your money and nutrients may be wasted because they're excess from what the crop can actually use. So it's important to get that soil test result back and then to follow those recommendations. Last but certainly not least, we really want to talk about the importance of taking care of soil. We're going to talk about that in another segment a little bit, but organic matter is a key part of managing soils for productivity. Well, that's all I've got for today. And if you have any questions, feel free to contact your county extension office. There's one in every one of the counties here in Oklahoma. And if they need a little more information than they've got there on site, they'll contact us and we'll be glad to work with you. Hope you have a great day, and thanks for listening.